In the last minutes of science episode, we learned about frataxin and what it does within the cell. We learned that frataxin plays an essential role in managing iron within the mitochondria, helping to generate specific complexes of iron and sulfur called iron sulfur clusters. Loss of frataxin decreases the number of iron sulfur clusters, compromises cell health, leads to iron accumulation in various tissues, and potentially to loss of cells through a process called ferroptosis. Ferrum is the Latin term for iron, and the source of the chemical symbol for iron, Fe. Ferroptosis, therefore, is a process of cell loss dependent on iron. When the most reactive form of iron accumulates in the cell, it produces reactive oxygen species, or ROS, that in turn cause widespread cell damage. ROS are molecules that damage cells and cause oxidative stress that we often hear about. One of the hallmarks of ferroptosis is the damage to the fat lipid-containing membranes that surround cells. This damage is called lipid peroxidation. Rob Wilson, Grazia Cotticelli and their colleagues at the Center of Excellence at Children's Hospital of Philadelphia, with collaborators at the University of Pittsburgh, have documented ferroptosis in cells from FA patients. Evidence of ferroptosis has also been seen in FA mouse models and in blood samples from FA patients. Knowing that frataxin loss contributes to ferroptosis has opened a new potential therapeutic avenue. Richard Posimato and his lab at the New York University School of Medicine discovered that it was possible to block the iron accumulation that is caused by loss of frataxin by removing iron regulatory proteins using genetic tools. FA cells with decreased levels of iron regulatory proteins were protected from ferroptosis. The results of this FARA and NIH supported work have been published in the journal Science Advances. We hope that this new understanding of a way to protect FA cells from ferroptosis can lead to a new kind of treatment approach. Finally, how is iron metabolism within the whole body affected in FA? Elisabetta Intelicato, who was inspired to work with FA patients as a medical student, is now at the Department of Neurology at the Medical University of Innsbruck, Austria, leading her own FA research. Dr. Intelicato is investigating if the hormonal balance that regulates iron in the whole body is working correctly in FA. The liver has the largest iron storage of the body, and it is the liver that produces the hormone hepcidin, which regulates the influx of iron into cells. In a study funded by FARA, Dr. Intelicato and her team are measuring hepcidin levels, as well as iron and copper in the blood of FA patients. In addition, they will also measure several iron-regulating genes and frataxin in the blood-derived white cells. Using MRI, the iron content in the liver of FA patients is also being measured. These studies spanning work in cells, animal models, and finally FA patients contribute to our understanding of how iron may affect the symptoms of FA and whether treatments focused on iron regulation may be helpful.
The project we just learned about is One Seed, One Tool, funded by your donations, championed by your engagement and your direct participation in FA research that is necessary to plant, tend, and nourish our garden of therapeutics. Thank you, FA community for bringing us closer to treatments.